When you think about the tides, it's natural to imagine that the water closest to the moon is being gravitationally attracted more, so the bulges of water should look like this. However, if you do a quick search, you'll find the actual distribution looks like this. There's bulges on both sides of the Earth. A quite weird result. Just a quick note here, these bulges represent forces and not water. But we'll get to that. Because it's forces, a better image of what we see would be this. Luckily, to understand the image, we can make a simulation that will reveal the exact distribution. Okay, to simulate it, let's start with a simpler case and only look at the horizontal line of the Earth. So let's go to space, and instead of examining Earth, let's put three balls in space instead. Since the gravitational force depends on the distance squared, as we know from Newton's equation, then the ball furthest from the moon should experience the weaker force, the ball in the middle should experience a stronger force, and the ball closest to the moon should experience the strongest force. So if the ball was just placed still in space, as time passes, this would happen. The difference in the gravitational force caused the balls to split. And from the point of view from the ball in the middle, the distance increases. If we draw a blue circle representing the Earth around the ball in the middle, and we draw the difference with the black line, this is what we will see as time passes. To really nail the point, let's mount the camera to follow the circle as well. That explains the tidal bulges of the side of the Earth. It's important to notice that this gravitational force from the moon is extremely weak, and it could not lift anything because the gravitational force from the Earth would be much stronger. You'll get to see soon why the water is then being pushed around, but it is not being lifted. Okay, now let's see what happens on the vertical line of the Earth. Let's see why it's being squeezed together. To understand that, let's do the same trick. Let's place three balls in space. The gravitational force should be directed towards the moon, right? So as time passes, the balls fly closer to each other, and therefore the distance decreases. So that's quite obvious, but we can draw the circle around the ball in the middle again, mount the camera to the middle ball, and also draw the difference with respect to the ball in the middle. So my animation suggests that we are crashing into the moon, but that doesn't happen because we have to remember the Earth and the moon are in orbit with each other. What is happening is if we mount the Earth, the moon will have a small gravitational attraction to the Earth, but the moon will also have an initial speed. If we mount that all around the Earth, we will get a full circle. So that is why the balls are not crashing into the moon, or the Earth isn't and the moon isn't crashing together, and why my animations are valid to showing the tidal bulges. Yeah, a really bad explanation of orbit. But now we arrive for the grand finale animation, because now we want to show this full distribution, this image right here. If we place a lot of balls around in the circle, and we simply tell the program to attract the balls according to Newton's gravitational formula, then, as time passes, this would happen. It's clear to see what's happening if we are drawing the differences with respect to this blue circle that's in the middle. So we see exactly this result here. And again, let's mount the camera to these balls, and it neatly reveals this distribution. The top is being squeezed, and the sides are being pushed apart. Fun fact, have you ever heard about being spaghettified if you come near a black hole? The tidal forces are just so strong, it literally rips you apart or stretches you apart. So I can show you again, if you draw this man here and I set a black hole, and that's just an extremely strong gravitational field, the balls closest to the moon in his legs are being attracted really strongly, but his head isn't being attracted that strong. So the difference in this gravitational force just ripped the man apart. Fun fact. So remember, what we saw was not water, but it is a distribution of vector forces. The Earth would only have these two water bodies if the Earth was completely covered in water. And we'll only see the water being distributed like this if there is no wind. The Earth shouldn't experience centrifugal force, should have a perfectly smooth and even depth sea floor, and should be no land. And there should be no gravitational attraction from the Sun, but there is. It's actually around 50% as strong as the Moon. So it's really an ideal picture. The actual distribution of water due to tides looked like this. Now I would like to explain why the water is being pushed around, because I claimed that this gravitational differential force is too weak to lift anything. So why are the water being pushed around? Well, okay, let's do something fun here. Let's, instead of vector forces, these arrows, let the forces being represented by something silly like these hair dryers pushing on something. So this would be the distribution of vector forces, and let's replace them with the hair dryers. So if you zoom in, and we see these vector forces, the hair dryers will just push the water around in the ocean and actually make a difference. But this force is extremely weak, and it could easily be interrupted by a rock or land. A lake is much smaller than the ocean, and so these combined forces by the hairdryers, or the vector forces, can't work together. There's tidal force in a cup of coffee, but they are just, the difference is just way too small to actually measure. And it's the same in the lake, it's too small. You need a huge area in order for these forces to build up. So full disclosure, as I mentioned, tides are actually quite complex. And in this little video, I didn't even mention how the sun influenced the tidal bulges and caused the neap tides and the spring tides. I didn't even talk about tidal acceleration, but that's for another day. This video was brought to you by very generous Patreon supporters. Thank you. Support these videos by becoming a Patreon, subscribing to the newsletter, or subscribing to YouTube.